Hello, and welcome to your technique video for the acid content of a commercial soda lamp. You should have already watched the background video, so by now you should have a basic understanding of the concepts behind the procedure that we will show you. Make sure you are following your safety rules. Goggles need to be worn at all times, and since we are working with acids and bases, make sure you flush any skin that comes in contact with them for 15 minutes. All of the solutions in this lab can be poured down the sink after you're done. The laboratory technique used today is referred to as a titration. First, you will perform a titration using a primary standard, which will be KHP in this lab. The standard solution will be a sodium hydroxide solution, and it will be placed in the burette for each trial. Typically, you must measure the concentration of the standard solution before using it. This process is referred to as standardizing the solution. Exercise 1 will allow us to standardize the sodium hydroxide solution. Set up your notebook to record your data. You will be performing at least 3 trials each for exercises 1 and 2. For both exercises, you will need to record the initial and the final volume in the burette. For exercise 1, you should record the mass of KHP used in each trial, and for exercise 2, you should record the volume of soda used in each trial. Since the sodium hydroxide solution will be in the burette for all of our trials, we need to prime the burette before using it. First, get a beaker of the sodium hydroxide solution. Select a burette from the drawer, then go to the sink. Fill a second beaker with distilled water. To prime the burette, you must first rinse out the burette with water, then add a small amount of the sodium hydroxide to the burette. Coat the inside surface of the burette by rotating the burette with the sodium hydroxide. Drain this small amount of solution through the tip and repeat at least 3 times. This will ensure that the concentration of the sodium hydroxide solution is the same for each trial, since any water used to clean the burette will have been removed in the rinses. Once the burette is primed, return to your lab bench and clamp it to a ring stand, not the bars on the lab benches, and lower it so that the top of the burette is below your eyes. Make sure the stopcock is in the horizontal position. Pour in the sodium hydroxide. Never try to add sodium hydroxide when the burette is above your head because it's very easy to spill it. Raise the burette back up. Make sure that there are no air bubbles in the tip. To remove bubbles, get a waste beaker and place it under the burette. Turn the stopcock to the vertical position to allow the solution to drain, and gently tap or flick the tip to allow the bubbles to rise out of the top. Turn the stopcock back to the horizontal position. Make sure that the O-ring is not loose. This can cause the burette to drip even when the stopcock is in the horizontal position. While one person is setting up the burette, another can be preparing the KHP solutions that will be used to standardize the sodium hydroxide solution. KHP is kept in the desiccator with the blue base. Take a bottle of KHP and replace the lid. Find the mass of a portion of KHP and record it in your notebook. Transfer the sample to an Erlenmeyer flask. One of the calculations in the In Your Notebook section will tell you about how much KHP you should use. Dissolve the solid in about 50 milliliters of water. KHP can take a while to dissolve, so prepare several samples at once so you don't have to wait as long. Cupping the bottom of the flask with your hand will help it dissolve. Once it has dissolved, add 1 to 2 drops of phenolphthalein. Record the initial volume of sodium hydroxide. Remember to record to 1 degree of uncertainty past the graduations on the burette. Now you are ready to begin. Until you have had some practice with titrations, it would be wise to let one group member control the stopcock and the other group member hold the flask. Open the stopcock to allow the sodium hydroxide to flow out while swirling the Erlenmeyer flask. You can let it flow out fast at first, but when you start to see pink where the drops are splashing in, you should slow down and go more dropwise by turning the stopcock to a more vertical position. If you think you are really close, you can add a half drop by carefully allowing a little drop to form on the tip of the burette, then touching the inside of the flask to it. Tilt the flask so that the drop goes into the rest of the solution. The titration is finished when a very light pink color persists after you swirl it. It may be helpful to put it on a white piece of paper and compare it to a beaker of water, since the color is very subtle. Record the final volume in the burette. If you let it go too far, it will turn a very bright pink. You should redo the titration if it looks like this at the end. You will repeat this procedure until you and your TA decide that the data is precise. To find out how much acid is present in soda, you will follow the exact same procedure. Before you start your titration, you will need to get rid of the carbonation. Accurately measure out about 100 milliliters of soda, then heat it in a beaker for about 15 minutes. Add water to bring the volume back to the starting volume. Pour about 25 milliliters in an Erlenmeyer flask and add some distilled water to make the volume great enough that the endpoint is easy to see. Follow the same titration procedure shown earlier. You will perform a total of 3 titrations of the soda. Hopefully by the end of this lab, you will become a pro at titrations. That's all we've got for this week.